a new challenger.
Yeah, so today we showed off two new characters for PlayStation All-Stars, Cole McGrath and Jak and Daxter. Cole McGrath, of course, from Infamous. I think a lot of people guessed that he would show up here. I think at San Diego Comic-Con makes a lot of sense. Cole McGrath is very much a superhero type. So we showed off a lot of his abilities, showed off some amp stuff, some ice stuff, and some electricity stuff. Then, of course, Jak and Daxter. Also a character I think people have been asking for a long time. Made sure to include a lot of cool interplay between Jak and Daxter. Then, of course, he's known for his guns, so he has a whole host of different guns that he uses. And then, of course, the eco powers, Dark Jak, Light Jak. Made sure to get all that stuff in there. So two very cool announcements. Yeah, the best way we refer to Cole, he's a character who deals with what the other opponents are doing to him, and he typically has something to counteract that with. He's a character who has a lot of functionality at all different ranges, so the amp gives him a lot of up-close melee, but his abilities, his electricity and his ice-based stuff also gives him a lot of medium to far range functionality as well. So he's a character who's equally at home, I think, at the very, very close range, mixing up there with like the Kratoses, but also the medium and the far range with like Erratic or Jak, actually. Yeah, so Cole's level 3 super, I believe it's called the Ionic Vortex. That was one of the, I think, the scene-stealing moments from E3 2010, I want to say, when they unveiled that ability. And so we knew that that particular moment had such a strong impact on a lot of the fans that we wanted to make sure that we included that as well. So, yeah, his level 3 super, but also his level 2 super is one of his famous attacks. It's that sort of sends the whole stream of icicles onto the bottom of the level, and anyone standing down there is going to get taken out. And then his kinetic blast, where he can pick objects up and throw them around in his game. We gave that actually to him for his level 1 super, so he can pick opponent up and throw him, and anyone who gets hit by the opponent actually dies too. So some really cool functionality. You got to play a lot with his abilities. So Jak and Daxter, I mean, they're known as a pair. You know, they have this such a cool interplay between them. So in a lot of Jak's melee attacks, Daxter will play a role in his throws. You'll see Daxter helping out in there. And it's just fun. I mean, he's one of our best animated characters, I feel, just being able to see such the personality in Daxter and Jak and some of them playing off of each other as well. But then Jak, like I said, has access to all of his guns and all the eco powers, and it pretty much takes those on in a solo capacity as well. Jak has, I want to say, 8 guns just in his normal moveset, and they all are good at dealing with different ranges and different distances. And he can also use them in the air, which is a very unique ability, that he can start an attack in the air and have that carry out onto the ground as well. So he's got his Reflexor, he's got his traditional blaster, and those are probably the attacks that he has with his greatest range. But he also has the Mass Inverter, which we showed off in our trailer. And the Mass Inverter is a really, really, really good gun for dealing with opponents who get too close in on him. He actually suspends gravity in this area around him, and you just kind of go floating off in space. It's a really super useful tool for him, because you're going to have a lot of guys to try to close that distance and make him pay for using all those long-range guns. For Jak's level 1 super, he does kind of his eco charge power-up. If you remember, like, when he used to step on an eco vent in Jak and Daxter, he'd sort of do this power-up attack, and so we gave that to him as his level 1 super. For his level 2 super, he does transform into Dark Jak temporarily and does this giant sort of area of effect smash. And then for his level 3 super, he turns into Light Jak, and he gets the full spectrum of Light Jak abilities. He goes around, he can suspend time a little bit, he can play with time, he's got these projectiles, he's flying around, causing a lot of chaos. So a really cool character, and really excited to have him. Character selection is, I'm going to say, the hardest thing we have to do in making PlayStation All-Stars. Not because the characters are hard to come by, but because the fans want to see so many characters, and sort of getting them all into the game is really the hard part. When it comes down to a character like Jak or even Cole, they have such a wide spectrum of functionality that comes over from their own games that selecting their movesets is actually kind of easy. Once you settle in on what that character is and what the essence of that character is, picking the right moves and how they fit into our world is kind of the easy part. But just listening to all of the fan requests for each individual character, I'd say that's the hardest part of the job. So, yeah, PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale will be out on PlayStation 3 and PS Vita October 23rd of this year.